cabin crew work, but all roles have to done by the cabin crew, their pros and cons, how airlines select the cabin crew. So let's start with the presentation. Here's the first slide that talks about air hostess, like how they dress up, how they look like after dressing up, their dressing sense. As we know that different airline has a different dressing styles and their grooming styles. So let's talk about from the starting. So here's the introduction of the presentation. This work is talk about the aptitude of the cabin crew, how they work, how the airlines select the cabin crew, international level or the domestic level. Every airline have a different ways of they every airline have a different criteria of selecting the cabin crew. So here is the some details about the cabin crew. So initially, cabin crew or flight attendant was known as a steward or stewardess from the very beginning. So air hostess and the airline crews employed by the airline, they work on the passenger safety. They guide the passenger to their seats. They serve the food to the passenger. So here are the basic details of the cabin crew, what basically they have to do. Here is the role of the airline. Sorry, here is the role of the cabin crew. They main focus on the safety of the passenger, first aid of the passenger, and the service. Service as in like if the passenger needs a food, so they serve that. If they need water and etc. So cabin crew serve to the passengers. Here is some details about the safety, how actually they have to perform. Air safety is a term coined by the theory investigation of a cannon a cabin crew flight failure. For example, sometimes every in the beginning of the every flight, air hostess or a cabin crew are advised to tell all the safety measures to the passengers, like how to wear the mask if there is any emergency, how they have to work on that particular thing. If the plane is about to take off or landing, they have to wear the mask or they have to pull up their seat belt. Here is a care about the first aid. The air cabin crew is, or each and every cabin crew is taught how they have to give the first aid to the passengers. In every flight, before every flight, past cabin crew are advised to recall all the first aid, all the emergency equipment, how they have to work it on, but if they have any emergency of the flight, how they have to work. We can call it like they are a mini doctor to the in the airline. They always help to the passenger if there is any heart attack. So they help in that as well. If there is an emergency delivery, so they can do that as well in the airplane. So they are trained as a doctor as well. So we can call it that they are a mini doctor in the airplane. Here is we talk about the service. So in service, as I talked about earlier as well, in service, cabin crew are advised to serve the food and the beverages like drinking water, coffees, and etc. If the passenger need any extra beverage, if they want to eat or they want to drink, so they can ask to the cabin crew, they will serve that. It happens in every flight, like whether it's domestic or the international. Here is something, here's the quality. If we talk about the selection process, so they have to go through so many selections like their qualification, their height, weight, BMI, and the grooming test, and so many details. So here's some details about the cabin crew selection process. Qualifying, all airline have a different qualification sectors, their eligibility, stability, and specification required. If we talk about eligibility, the candidate must require excellent communication skill. They need to know swimming for the swimming is a must in the international cases, but in domestic, there is no must in the swimming. Their BMI needs to be equal according to their preference. Basic BMI is 20 to 24 for every airline for girls. They need to have a passport. Passport is mandatory for each and every cabin crew. And the basic qualification of each and every cabin crew is 10 plus 2. If we talk about stability, the airline manager will look up to the passenger who will be the best person for the cabin crew. The minimum required are as follows, as I mentioned in the screen as well, is maturity, friendly nature, good listener, leadership quality, as the cabin crew must have the leadership quality and the pleasing way of serving each and everything, good communicators, the knowledge if there is any emergency or any fight, like some fight, or if a passenger is not satisfied with the service, so they need to know how to handle that particular passenger, how to deal with that particular passenger. And if we talk about specific requirements, so here are some details. Airline connect their personal specialization according to their own health standards. So for example, if you take an example, so an airline identify and adapt an increase in the number of crew language speakers in a requirement, that then a language ability may help to produce. Simply, airline are looking for the right person who can contribute in their airline, who can help them to grow their airline as fast as they can, with the good communication and everything. There is the type of job roles for the air hostess. There are many types of air hostess. If we say there are student air hostess, there are senior air hostess, the junior, and if you talk out, here's some details of the airline, the air hostess, the cabin crew, they require the overhead related to the passenger. So once they are on board and flight. Second is the air steward and air steward. So their job involves unnecessary safety and of the passenger. They basically work on the passenger's safety. Next, if we talk about the senior flight attendant. So they are the senior most often in the flight. They help, they guide the junior and they assist them how they have to work and how they have to present the passengers and they have to deal. Next, is ground staff. In ground staff, they are basically not a cabin crew, but still they are part of a airline restaurant. So in ground staff, they help in the ticketing department. They guide the checking, they help in checking, they help passenger in the helping, assisting them where they have to go for to board their flight. Next is trainer. They are responsible for coordinating and promoting the air hostess cabin crew regarding on-flight duties. Trainers are recruit and recruiters help the cabin crew. Basically, they help to the cabin crew to how they have to perform in the airline. As in, they take a pre-test of the air cabin crew before going to a board. They check their grooming. They check their once they recheck their communication skill. They give one situation to the cabin crew and ask them how you are going to deal with that particular situation. And the crew members. These are the few more members of the airline. Here is some details of the cabin crew, how they basically work on board. At first, the second picture is showing their cabin crew is assisting a child. Next is showing us that the cabin crew is helping one passenger in managing their bag. Next is showing the cabin crew is helping a passenger to their seat. Next is employees' opportunity in the cabin crew. So if we talk about that, how many roles or opportunity a cabin crew have in the airlines? So it's their communicate airline, they help, they go to a corporate airline, air hostess training institute also they can join once they have been cabin crew and they have fulfilled their duty time period. So they can join an institute to teach other girls how to become a cabin crew, how they work in everything. They can become a trainer in the institute or they can become the trainer in the airline itself. So it will help with both the ex-cabin crew and the upcoming cabin crew. They help in the both to improve their communication skills, their way of knowledge, the way of teaching. They can help both of them. Next, it's about the cabin crew. Here are some details. Here is a list of the airlines, how many airlines we have in all over India. There's some basics are Indigo, Air India, Jet Airways, Spiceship. On international level, we have our Etihad Airline, Emirates, Thai Airways, Air China, Eva Airlines, Singapore Airlines, and there are many more airlines who are cabin crew and who serve each and every passenger as a treat their passenger as a god. Here is the pictures of some airline. There's a top airline. If some children are happen, they are not directly able to join the airline. So what they do, they just start, they join the any institute to become a pre-trained, to become pre-trained how cabin crew work, how they have to work on board, how they have to walk, how they have to dress up, how they have to groom yourself. So here's a list of the few institute or colleges who teach to become a cabin crew. They train girls and our boys to become a cabin crew. Franklin Institute of Air Hostess Training. This is the India's oneest institute of who trains the air cabin crew. It's the Bombay Flight Bombay Flight Club College of Aviation in Mumbai. So here's a list of the few more colleges and institutes. Here's a uniform of few institutes of the cabin crew. First is of all from Franklin Institute of the Air Hostess. Here's a career opportunities and salary. If we go for the salary purposes, like airline, no doubt airline is providing n number of salaries. Like there is no comparison in the salary. They are more, almost highest paid girls in the India. Airline pays very much to the cabin crew. It starts from 30,000 from the beginning. It starts from the 30,000 and it go for the 45,000 or above that on the domestic level. And if we go for the international level, so it increased to the 2 lakhs or more than that. It depends on the airline to airline, how they provide the salary to their cabin crew. And it depends on the position, like how old they are in this industry. As old as you are, so you will get that much on the airline. As a recommendation, paid according to experience. Freshers may earn between 1600 and more. Here's a job profile. Here's a job profile. Welcome passenger. How they have to work there. They need to welcome to the passenger, introducing safety procedure to the passengers, providing food and drink to the passengers, and attending passenger during a certain critical situation, providing first aid to them at the time of first aid. As I told you, the first aid, they have already taught how to do the first aid, how to help the passenger if he or she has had a heart attack or if any pregnant lady have an emergency delivery. So they are pre-known in each and every step, how they have to do, what they have to do. Next is pros and cons of becoming a cabin crew. So as we all know, that every industry and every work have their own pros and cons of being a part of that particular industry. So if we talk about the pros of becoming a cabin crew, the biggest of this particular industry, becoming a cabin crew, is that we can travel all over the world without paying from our pocket. And we earn from that. Like we are traveling all over the world, and for traveling as well, we are getting money as our salary. So according to me, this is the best pro as of now for this particular job. Because if we are travel all over the world, so we have to pay it from our pocket. But in this industry, we are going to travel all over the world and we are getting paid for that particular thing by serving passengers, by helping them, by feeding them. And in this industry, next best pro, according to me, is we meet different cultures, passengers. Like in one flight, there are n number of passengers, there are n number of cultures, passengers. We learn how they are, we can learn from them so many things. So this is one of the best part according to me, being a cabin crew. The most of the airline offers their employees for a discount for a free ticket. Or if we talk about like sometime what most of the airline, what they do at the end of the year or all over the year, they provide 2 or 3 free tickets to the cabin crew, or they provide some discount to the passenger, to the cabin crew. If they want to travel, or one of their family members wants to travel, so they can travel. So this is one of the best pros of being a cabin crew. Next are the cons of becoming a cabin crew. So cons of, according to me, there is no fixed timing of being a cabin crew. Like if in the morning you are in India, maybe in the night you are somewhere else apart from India. So unless we don't have specific time of taking rest, although airline provide the enough time to take rest, but still, there are no specific time of being there is no specific time for resting. And this we don't know where we are going to celebrate our respective festivals. We are away from our families. So here is some cons of being a cabin crew. Some question asked by the girl and boys that what we have to do for if to become a cabin crew, and what salary we get. What is the procedure of being a cabin crew? So here's some question asked by the students becoming a cabin crew. The main question asked by the students is, what is the qualification of being a cabin crew? And what is the age of being a cabin crew? So as per the reaching every airline, the basic qualification of being a cabin crew is 10 plus 2. If we have done with the 10 plus 2, so we can join the airline by clearing their interviews. So the minimum age of being a cabin crew is 18. If we are 18, so we can go for the interview. And if we selected in that particular interview, so we can join particular airline. Next is, what does cabin crew and airline do? Here's the next question is, what airline and cabin crew and air hostess do after becoming a air hostess? So if we say in short, I can say that they serve passengers. They basically do hospitality. Hospitality means they serve passengers. They help them in their food. They guide them to their seats. They serve their food. They provide drinks in case of any emergency. They help everyone to come out from that particular emergency, whether it's they have emergency on board or off board. They help each and everyone. There is no discrimination between caste, age, or color and everything. So they help each and everyone on an equal level. They try their best to help them. Next question was asked by so many students for becoming a cabin, future cabin crew, is do airline hire a married cabin crew? So no, airline did not hire any married girl for a cabin crew. Because airline have a up and down, unbalanced timing for airline, for flight. So it might be possible that the in-house of that particular girl will not allow them to be cabin crew, so that's why they preferred unmarried girls over the married girls. So next question is, this graduation is necessary for being a cabin crew? So as I told you that 10 plus 2 is a basic qualification for being a cabin crew. Although if you are graduates, it helps you to get it's type of plus point in your qualification of being a cabin crew. But there is no any as such specification that you have to be a graduate to become a cabin crew. Next question was asked by so many questions, is pilot a part of cabin crew? So no, pilot and cabin crew both are different. Pilot is supposed to drive a plane. They have n number of responsibility on their platform, and cabin crew have different responsibilities on them. So they both are different. Their work are different. Their jobs are different. Their responsibilities are different. Their way of doing work are different. Next, do airline get the holidays? So yes, of course, cabin crew get the holidays according to their busy schedule or according to their ship schedule and according to airline preferences. And next question is swimming is necessary for being a cabin crew? So swimming is not necessary for being in cabin crew in domestic airline, but if you go for the international airline, so swimming is must for every cabin crew. To become a cabin crew, we need every girl or a boy need to know how to swim. So here is some basic presentation from my end. Here is the uniforms of few airlines, how they dress up their cabin crew, how they groom their airline cabin crew, how they're supposed to look like in front of the passengers or other staff members. Get some pictures of the air cabin crew. This is from my end. Thank you so much for being a part of this.